Thank you, Chair. I think, as you also indicated, I'm going to ask my colleagues to also come in and address, sorry, some of the questions and comments that were raised. But I want to start here, Chairperson, by saying when the minister joined the department, he had several stakeholder engagements with the industry. And he was responding to anyone where he could help it to accommodate those particular meetings. Anyone who was seeking for platform to engage with him, he had those meetings. And those count to well over 10 different stakeholder engagement, going up to 20. Now, upon having those engagements, including an engagement that Minister had with CCIFSA in Cape Town, upon what was emerging and what was coming out of those engagements, Minister then made a decision that it's not going to be possible for him to continue having individual meetings with different stakeholders as and when they approach him. Hence, the idea of the Bosberaad came about as a result of a need to put together all the stakeholders, key stakeholders, role players within the cultural and creative industry. That Bosberaad that took place on the 29th and the 30th of September. CCIFSA was also amongst other federations like AboSouthCIF and others that Minister had had. CCIFSA was also made aware that there was going to be that particular Bosberaad at that meeting in Cape Town. And in such a way that there was even a commitment from the minister that that Bosberaad will happen within this number of days. And indeed, it did take place. Now, I just wanted to explain that part, Chairperson, because the calling of the Bosberaad, from my understanding, it wasn't an intention to do away or to shut down any existing structure, but it was to create a platform where the stakeholders, the role players, and anyone who could be able to come to that particular Bosberaad. Now, what we were doing, in fact, President, we ended up not with 50 plus, we had close to 70 plus. Different organizations that came there. And we were not going to turn anyone down, Chairperson, who was saying they've got a national footprint. Because the proof of whether or not they are a national footprint wasn't actually the main objective in terms of the Bosberaad. But the proof was actually going to come out of the process that is now actually being followed. Now, subsequent to that meeting, that Bosberaad of the 29th and 30th of September, again, there was a commitment that was made by the minister that within this particular time frame, he would actually convene a meeting with all of those that they were nominating. Now, in the Bosberaad of 29th and 30th, Chairperson that I keep referring to, all the organizations that wanted to do presentations were given an opportunity to present. Everyone was going up to the stage doing presentations. Some came with prepared presentations. Some that had not prepared presentations were also given an opportunity to verbally present, including CCIFSA. Now, what actually came out of that particular 2 days? That then led to the nomination of representatives across sector, Chairperson. We are using a UNESCO classification, which Honorable Eugene is Tetwa is aware of. That's the classification we use. We look at all the cultural domains and the identification of the sector clusters, because we wanted a manageable figure, came as a result of looking at those cultural domains and looking at all the different disciplines, subsectors within those cultural domains. Now, the sector nominated, they nominated people that they called representatives, again, sitting to a number of about 70 plus, including CCIFSA. CCIFSA was also represented. And then, Chairperson, on the 28th of October, we then had a meeting where all these people that were actually nominated by the different sectors came to a meeting, and minister gave feedback. And the feedback that was given to the minister was based on what the Bosberaad had said. The issues that people were raising there, representative practitioners were raising, we ended up, Chairperson, with about 12 different interventions that were raised in the Bosberaad. So at that meeting of the 28th of October, feedback was actually given to the members. We gave back the document that came out of the Bosberaad resolutions, but also minister then presented a proposed funding model. And given the concerns that were actually shared with minister, both at the stakeholder engagements and at the Bosberaad, minister made a recommendation, which obviously he did say, I would agree, that as the minister, this is the recommendation that he's coming forward with for the sector to be able to support each other. The 2 million that the president makes reference to is not the cost for programs, Chairperson, and projects. We know very well that you cannot be able to organize an event. It's not for sectors to organize events, but it's for these 16 clusters to then be able to organize themselves and create a platform where they can form networks, where they can be able to seek support, not just from government, but also seek support from private sector and other sources of funding. So if it's a crafter, the crafters are being given an opportunity now to organize themselves, get funding from the department to form their own boards and be able to organize themselves. That is not money for them to go organize events, etc. Subsequent to the meeting of the 28th of October, we then wrote to all those representatives that were chosen by the sector, not by the department, that were chosen by the sector. We wrote to all of them to say, this is the guidelines that we are providing. And the guidelines are talking to the fact that because you have been nominated to represent visual artists, you have been nominated to represent crafters, you need to actually go out and get other representatives to a minimum, or sorry, maximum of 10. And those are going to serve in the structure that is a coordinating structure for that sector. Now, the objective here, Chairperson, is for the sector to be supported the way it said it wanted to be supported at the Bosberaad. People like Arthur were not denied an opportunity to attend. Arthur has formed a SIGA, an organization from SIGA. SIGA was there. SIGA was represented at both the Bosberaad and the session that took place subsequent to that. And as I said, Chairperson, we ended up actually allowing people to actually come as they were coming forward to say, I'm also in it. And because the objective at that stage was not to actually leave out anyone, but to allow everybody an engagement platform, that is what happened. There is no intention, as far as I know, from the side of the minister to shut down CCIFSA. And he has communicated that one very clearly. But his approach, which he tabled to the sector representatives, was that he wants to work directly with the sectors because of the outcry that has been happening in the industry across different cultural domains. So I wanted just to start there, Chairperson. Obviously, I might not have answers personally to all the questions that go back to 2014, 2016, because I had not joined the department, which is why I said earlier on, I've brought with me in this meeting colleagues that were there at that time. However, I need to say, Chairperson, at the time in 2020, 21, when I joined the department, the new leadership had been appointed, which is under the President Joy, who was talking earlier on. And there are systems, Chairperson, that we have put in place. And those systems, Honorable Mthethwa, are based on the report which, upon joining this department, I was given an investigation report that had investigated CCIFSA. And That report, Honorable Mthethwa, as far as I know, was shared with him, but I stand to be corrected. And it had very specific recommendations. I don't have it in front of me, but I'm recalling from memory, Chair. Specific instructions, for instance, recommendations, for instance, it was highlighted that CCIFSA did not have policies in place. It was highlighted that the issue of governance were actually not being done in terms of drawing clear roles and responsibility, amongst other things that were recommended in that investigation. That was communicated to CCIFSA, and that is why they were then able to have a policy conference to develop policies, and that is why they were able to then demarcate the responsibilities in terms of not them playing all the roles as what used to happen prior to that investigation. As I conclude, Chairperson, just my opening remarks in response, I also just wanted to also indicate that perhaps it is important for us, Chairperson, to highlight the fact that we are not saying we're not able to play oversight over CCIFSA. What I was saying, Chairperson, is that they are not an entity, which means there is no founding piece of legislation. However, like any other structure organization that we fund, they are subjected to the PFMA provisions and prescripts, and we sign an MOA with them that then outlines the specific compliances that need to come about. Chairperson, I just wanted to, and they are complying to that. They are doing that. They are submitting MOAs, business plans in line with that. That's the oversight that we are playing. I wanted just to conclude by saying, before I ask Mr. Mbiba, who was there at that time, I'm not putting you under the bus, Mr. Mbiba, but I'm just asking that you assist us because you've got that institutional memory, which some of us do not have. I wanted just to indicate, Chairperson, that we did ask the old executive to attend this meeting. Mr. Tony, the president, is the one that the project manager, Mr. Tuli, was engaging with. Up until Friday, Chairperson, our understanding that Mr. Tony and one other member whose name is slipping my mind was going to attend. And then they communicated, I'm made to believe on Friday, that because they had done a handover, they don't believe that they need to be part of this meeting. However, Chair, I do share your sentiments around a need to summon the old brigade of this particular CCIFSA, because quite a number of questions that were asked, including those from Honorable Member Mthethwa, they are in a better position to respond to around what happened in their task team meetings and all those things. But if you allow me, I'm pausing, Chair, because I see a hand after me, after the Chair, if you allow my colleagues, Mr. Mbiba in particular, to then come in with address some of the comments and questions. Thank you, Chair.